Hello everyone, we're live with Bana Live, episode 3, our third episode in our monthly live stream show where we bring you the latest gameplay, exclusives, previews, news recap, giveaways, contests and more, all on our games on Bana Namco Entertainment Games. My name is Isaac, I'll be your host tonight and I'm super excited to be here with you today. And we'll talk about a bunch of games that were included in our RPG tour that we did last week across Europe, where we had our producers come from Japan and go visit press in different countries to bring you all the latest info. We'll talk today about three games, Sword Art Online Holorealization. I'll take you through the latest updates and announcements, including multiplayer mode, character customization, and our latest trailer premiered here tonight. We'll talk about Tales of Berseria and a bunch of news recap and all the announcements we did lately with special guest Andao, product manager on the game. We'll finish with Galitra with product manager Jerome. We'll talk about all the things we announced last Friday. We announced a bunch of new information, including pre-order, special offer, and we'll talk about the game, the story, the universe, and characters, and everything about God Eater. And of course, we'll finish with a special contest, a chance to win a PlayStation 4. You need to stick around and stay tuned till the end of the show to find out how to win. We hope you'll like the show today. Let's get started. See you in just a bit with Sword Art Online. And we're back. Hope you're ready. We're going to talk about Sword Art Online Holorealization. Actually, Sword Art Online Holorealization, sorry, is the upcoming Sword Art Online video game based on the light novel turned anime franchise. You may be familiar with it. It's coming November 2016 on PS4 and PS Vita. And if you're not familiar with Sword Art Online, let me give you just a quick rundown. So Sword Art Online was originally a Japanese light novel who became an anime and then worldwide phenomenon. Which focuses on the story of our Earth in the near future, where virtual reality has really improved and become an incredible way to experience new sensations. So when you plug into VR in the world of SAO, you're really like another world. You can feel, touch, smell, and you're really like into the game. And so the story follows Kirito, Asuna, and 10,000 other players who end up trapped in the VR game. And the only way to escape is to clear the game, and if you try to escape by, you know, disconnecting the VR headset or something else, you die. And if you die in the game, you die in real life. So yeah, pretty dangerous. I won't spoil you all that happens. I'll just spoil you, of course, the end. They survive, of course, because our games is based in the future of that. And actually, Sword Art Online Holorealization takes place a few years later when the original game that trapped people is resurrected as a new game. But we don't know really more details than that. And our story follows Kirito and his friends as they jump back into the game and jump back into this nostalgic world that they once knew, but that's still different all the same. And this time the mystery will focus on a mysterious NPC called Premier. And of course we'll have more to say in the future about that, so stay tuned. So actually, in Sword Art Online Holorealization, as you can see in the next video, you'll be able to customize your character. So we've really looked head back to the customization features in Sword Art Online. You probably played Lost Song, and that was your main feedback as a player. We want more features, we want more ways to customize your character, and we've really gone back and improved all the ways you can do that. So as you can see on the screen, you have a lot of options, and you can customize your character to make it your own, really. And it's really impressive, actually, how two characters can really be not the same. They really don't look alike, and you can make it your own and really unique. And that will help you, actually, because you'll need to customize your character, because you'll be able to play, as you can see in the next video, you'll be able to play online. So we've just announced the multiplayer mode, which we'll see in just a bit in the next video. We just announced the multiplayer mode, where you'll be able to play with up to 3 other friends and 4 AI players. So you'll be able to party up with 8 people total online. That's pretty impressive, actually. And so you'll be able to make big parties and play the game, and as you can tell, it's sort of a mix, sort of an MMO, sort of not really. It's a mix between online and offline. You can follow the main story and the quests and the missions with cutscenes, intrigue, characters, and you can go and do side quests and play, and so you can always play with your friends or play with AI characters. So what's really interesting is obviously you can really just head into the world and just meet random encounters, like big monsters that can end up turning into boss fights, and you have to you'll need the help of your friends and the help of your, of course, AI characters to claim victory. Actually, the game story, which is also a big part of the game, is supervised by the original author, Reiki Kawahara, so that's pretty cool. And you'll be able to meet all the characters you know about Sword Art Online, so Kirito, Asuna, but also Lisbeth, Sirika, Shinon, which is my favorite character, and we have many more to announce in the coming month as we get closer to the release. So don't forget, Sword Art Online Hollow Realization is coming in November 2016 on PS4 and PS Vita. And yeah, let's watch the latest trailer, premiering live on Banna Live.
PEGI 12.
今から一月ほど前に発表された完全新作のバーチャル MMORPG。 そのクローズドベータテストに俺たちは参加し、 NPC の少女と出会った。ゲームの名はソードアートオリジン。人が遊ぶために生まれたはずのこの仮想世界は人なんて求めていなかった。ソードアートオンラインホローリアリゼーション。俺たちが新たにログインしたゲームの舞台は一つにつながる大地、アイングラウンド。ここで新たな冒険が始まる。ここはこのゲームでの始まりの街だ。たくさんの出会いやイベントも豊富に用意されているらしいぞ。最大4人でパーティーを組んでフィールドへ繰り出そう。敵を見つけたらステップで接近、隙をついてソードスキルを叩き込め。バトル中は自分から指示を出す以外に仲間同士でもいろいろな提案が出る。自分以外の3人の様子をチェックしてバグをかけたり、タイミングを合わせてコンボをつなげたり、まあいろいろやることあるけど、みんなと戦うっていいよな。それから扱える武器もいくつかあるみたいだ。いろんな武器を試してみるか。お、マルチプレイか。プレイヤーキャラを自由にカスタムして、プレイヤー4人、パートナーキャラ4人の疑似8人パーティーでバトルができるぞ。力を合わせて強敵を打ち倒せ。さあ誰と一緒に冒険に行こうか。準備 OK だ。リンクスタート。
頑張るわね。任せておいて。貴重な武器の1本や2本自分で作ってみせるわ。
それじゃ続きは今度。
なんかこれからみんなで頑張るぞって雰囲気でいいですね。
うわあ、なんか危なそうな予感がするわよ。
やっほー、やっと出てこれた。
どんなお宝が出るかな。
NPC の少女プレミア。
そういえばプレミアとは私の名前でした。
何も設定がない NPC なんて存在するのか。
考えるって名前を。
今は私たちで守ってあげましょう。
プレミアちゃんってお腹すくのか。
つまりグッジョブです。
実はね、レアアイテムをゲットしちゃったのよ。
プレミアちゃんの噂って聞いた。
人の存在がこの世界を見にくくする。
NPC が SAO の時より進化しているってことなのかな。
うんうん、分かればよし。
なぜ元のキャラがリポップしないんだ。
それってつまり死んじゃうってことだよね。
こんな世界には最初からいらない。
全て消えてしまえばいい。
ソードアートオンラインホローリアリゼーション。
PEGI 12.
And we're back, and we're going to talk about Tales of Berseria with special guest Ando, project manager on Tales of Berseria. Hello, Ando.
Hello, Isaac. Hello, guys.
How are you today?
I'm very good. You?
I'm good. Actually, you're back from that last time.
Yes, I know, because last time Tony was like, hey, can you talk about Tales of? And I was like, I don't know, but now is the right time.
Yes, now it is. We actually announced lots of information recently, last Friday, mm-hmm. as part of our RPG tour. And today we're going to recap all this information. So yeah, we announced Tales of Berseria last December at Jump Festa. And of course, it's the latest game in the Tales of series. So can you tell us a bit more about Tales of Berseria?
Yeah, so it's a JRPG game from a long-running series. Actually, Tales of celebrated its 20th birthday last year.
Yeah.
So for the very first time in Tales of, you're going to play a solo heroine. And as you know, or maybe not, in every Tales of games, mm-hmm. there is a central theme. And this time, it's emotion versus reason.
Emotion versus reason. That's pretty cool, actually. I like that theme.
So you're going to follow Velvet, our heroine, in a quest for revenge.
Okay.
And of course, you're going to meet along the way a lot of characters to help you and join in the adventure.
Of course, as is usual with Tales. So... Yeah. Let's talk a bit about the world. So what sort of world does the story, you know, evolve into?
It's a world made of a lot of different islands. So you have a lot of variation in the climate, the temperature, and the lifestyle of the civilians. It's actually governed by Holy Mikdem Kingdom.
Okay.
So in this kingdom, you have humans and Malak living together.
Okay.
And Malak actually have the power to harness nature.
Okay, interesting.
So they're exploited by exorcists, whose role is actually to defend humans against demons.
Okay, so we have humans and Malak. We have the kingdom governing all that, all the land. And the Malak are exploited by exorcists, who also do good, I guess, because they fight against demons to protect the humans. So demons. So where do demons come from?
It's coming from demon blight. So it's actually a disease that change people into demons. But some of them manage to keep rational, just like Velvet.
Right. So yeah, Velvet was able to withstand, I guess, demon bite just a bit.
Yeah.
So yeah, Velvet, it's one of the main characters. Let's talk about the other characters announced so far.
Well, we have six other characters. Yeah, the first one is Lafisset.
Show them on screen, actually.
Yes. So we have Lafisset. He's a 10-year-old boy, a Malak boy. So as all the others, he's been exploited and he doesn't really have any personality.
Okay, yeah. He's pretty cute, actually.
Cute little boy. Then we have Rokuro. So he's a cool samurai and he also has been affected by demon blight, just like Velvet.
Yeah. Actually, he's one of my favorite characters because I love samurais, obviously. I really like them. They're pretty cool. But he's like colorful. He has a cool sword and he has his tattoo thing going.
And his hair. Covering half of his face. It's like mysterious. Yeah.
I love Rokuro.
Then we have Majilu.
Okay.
So she's a witch and she's just standing by and watching the world. So did you see her skirt?
Yes, I love her skirt. Look
Super
at her skirt.
Cool. Yeah.
Her skirt is made of books.
Yeah.
That is insane. I'm really looking forward to cosplayers. Because
we want to see some pictures.
They're going to do it. They're going to put books on them and do the skirt like that. So that's pretty awesome. I'm looking forward to it.
Then we have cute little curator. He's also a Malak. It's Bienfu.
Bienfu. Yeah, he looks pretty cute.
He's super cute with his hat covering his face and like his eyes.
And
it
looks like a gift kind of.
His hat.
They're always do pretty cute mascots in Tales games. We know we had Rollo, we had Tipo, we had Norman in the series.
Yes.
And now Bienfu. Looking forward to him.
Yeah. Then we have Eleanor. So she's just a female exorcist.
Interesting. Who joins the party in the game?
Yeah.
Seems like there's going to be some conflict, I guess, because exorcists and Velvet.
Yeah, that's the main conflict.
Yeah. All things Tales, and we did extensive character profiles on all the characters. So yeah, join the community, leave us a comment, and let us know who's your favorite.
Lot of information on the blog. Check it out.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So if you want to know more about all the Tales of Berseria characters we announced today, just head to blog.talesofgame.com, your official blog on all things Tales, and we did extensive character profiles on all the characters. So yeah, join the community, leave us a comment, and let us know who's your favorite.
Lot of information on the blog. Check it out.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So when I think about a Tales of game, I think about story, I think about characters, I also think about gameplay, you know, the battle system.
Yes.
So what's special about the battle system this time around?
Well, you know, like we do in every Tales of game, we improve the battle system.
Right.
So this time we have what we call the Liberation Linear Motion Battle System.
Interesting.
So, Liberation. Yes, because you have a lot more freedom to fight, because you'll be able to make your own combination of buttons to create your arte combo.
Interesting. So you can customize each button on the PS4 controller or wherever you're playing.
Yeah, totally. You can put whatever buttons you want to do whatever technique you want.
Cool. That's pretty cool.
Yes. And then we also have a cool new feature, which is called Soul.
Okay.
So you can actually steal souls during battles from your enemies on the field. And that allows you to use it later in battles with special techniques, which are called Break Soul.
Interesting.
So each of the characters have one specific Brexel.
Okay.
And for instance, Velvet has a cool consuming glow.
Yeah, which I guess is caused by Demon Bite.
Yes.
That's pretty cool. I like that about her, her special glow.
Yeah. And I think there's a third thing I'd like to mention.
Okay.
It's the fact that now during the battles, you can really move the camera around as you want with the stick. So it allows you to have much more freedom and use a lot of different angles during your battle.
Interesting. So you can finally control the camera.
Yes.
That's pretty cool, actually.
First time.
Yeah, they had feedback about the camera last time, so it's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yes.
So anything else you want to tell us before we move on to the God Eater, actually?
I think there is one cool thing I want to talk about.
I think I know what you're going to say.
And I think you guys are going to be happy about it.
Yes, I think you will too.
It is.
Drum roll.
60 FPS.
60 FPS. Oh my God. That's the best news of the year, I think.
I know.
60 FPS. I'm really curious about if you guys knew in the chat. Yeah, 60 FPS coming to Tales of Vesperia.
Yeah, coming early 2017 on PS4 and PC.
So yeah, look forward to it. I'm sure we'll have much more to say and still to reveal about Tales of Vesperia.
Yeah, I hope to come back next month.
You're welcome anytime.
Bring you more news.
Yes, looking forward to it. I'm really excited. I love Tales of. I love
Me
Tales of Vesperia. Looks amazing. It's gonna be fun.
Yes.
Yeah. So yeah, we're gonna leave you with the latest Tales of trailer, and after that, we'll be back with God Eater and special guest Jerome to talk about all the info we revealed, and of course, coming up at the end of the show, a chance to win the PlayStation 4. So stay tuned. See you in a bit.
Bye bye.
どうやら人間じゃないようだな。どけ、侍と。お前も食らう。非情の戦いは非情をもって制すべし。それがあんたたちの断りよね。やりなさい、2番。寝る。わかんない。そういう時は言えばいい。好きか嫌いか楽しいか怖いか。あんたは生きてるんだから。後方から砲撃。 海賊船だ。あの旗は。僕は生きてる。ベルベットと一緒に行く。
And we're back. So yeah, sorry about that. We had a little technical difficulties, but all is fixed now. So yeah, just in case you missed it, I'm here with Jerome, product manager on God Eater. We're going to talk about God Eater today because we announced a lot of information last Friday on the game.
Yeah. So actually what we announced was first the fact that God Eater Resurrection and God Eater 2 Rage Burst will be out the 30th of August.
Yeah, worldwide release, actually. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, within Europe, Australia, America, North, LATAM or so, Latin America.
Yep.
So, really excited. And afterwards, let's say, we had another announcement, and this was really an exciting one. Every time you buy God Eater 2 Rage Burst,
yes,
we offer you God Eater Resurrection.
Two for one. That's pretty cool, actually.
So really, the idea behind all of this is the fact that we want you guys to discover the whole universe. And with that, you can do it with these two games. So for us, we really wanted to spoil you with elements like, you know, we are going to talk about each game afterwards.
Yeah, of course.
But really having God Eater Resurrection offered every time you were purchasing God Eater 2 Rage Burst.
So you buy God Eater 2 Rage Burst and you'll get a code to redeem God Eater Resurrection on our website.
Let's say if you buy it on the with the physical box product.
Yeah, yes, which is available on PS4 and PS Vita.
PS4 and PS Vita. You get this code on the website. You go on the website and then you redeem it against, you know, a PlayStation PSN code.
Yeah, and then you can get the game.
But if you buy God Eater 2 Rage Burst on the digital stores, like Steam, for instance, for PC, because it's also on PC.
Yeah.
For the first time.
Yes.
And and also for on the PSN, you have the two games at once. So it's totally transparent for
automatic.
You
get the games. That's pretty cool, actually. So we also announced lots of pre-order bonuses if you pre-order the game.
Yeah, yeah.
So let's talk about that.
Yeah, so for the bonuses, every time you pre-order God Eater 2 Rage Burst, you have exclusive costumes. So you have to keep in mind three elements. First is SAO, Sold Out Online.
Yes,
so
which we talked about earlier, actually.
Yeah. And you have two costumes for Sold Out Online. You have Asuna and Kirito.
Yes, two main characters.
And the other element is Tales of Zestiria.
Yes, Tales of Zestiria.
Yeah. We have we will have the costume of Mikleo and Sorei. So with these two costumes, we think that we will be able to play in the world of God Eater with your favorite license.
Yeah, your elements from those games. So that's pretty cool, actually, because those are games of ours.
Yeah, that's game of ours.
We're crossing over all our games. I really like that.
Last but not least, let's say we have another one, three-in-one, which is Tokyo Ghoul.
Tokyo Ghoul.
I don't know if you know, guys, this license, but
this manga is pretty cool, yeah.
Pretty cool. And you will have a specific mask and costumes, that depicts the specific characters of Tokyo Ghoul. So if you don't know this license, I invite you to have a look at it.
Yeah, you should check out the manga or the anime. It's really good.
Yeah.
And Tokyo Ghoul is really fun.
When pre-ordering the game, you therefore have all these costumes.
That's awesome.
But that's not all.
No, I mean, buy one, get one, get pre-order bonuses. That's pretty... why not become a fan?
And we have another surprise, but not today. Like, keep you posted.
Okay, yeah, stay tuned. Guess you're maybe we'll be back on a future stream to tell us about the surprise.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you know what? Let's talk a bit more about the game itself. Can you tell us a bit more about the universe of God Eater?
Yeah, so God Eater, it's actually the real world. So it's a post-apocalyptic world, meaning that... there were boundaries with countries such as Japan, France, Americas. And here, because there is these monsters that are coming into these lands, they've destroyed everything. Okay. And humanity is just now on ghettos, sheltered ghettos, and they are really on the brink of,
extinction. Okay.
So you are in this post-apocalyptic world, and the only ones who can help you and protect you are an elite squad, which is called the God Eater. So God Eater, that's why the name of the license.
Pretty cool game, yeah. And pretty cool game, I like it.
Actually, this is the only members that can kill these monsters, and that's really important. And all these members are organized beneath the Fenrir organization. So having the possibility to play in this world is really cool because you can experience this destroyed universe and discover a really genuine post-apocalyptic world happening around to 2070s.
So that's pretty cool, actually. I mean, you had me at post-apocalyptic world, big monsters, destruction. That's already in. Like, yeah. I mean, I'm ready.
And if you want to have a sneak peek on the world itself, yeah. You can watch the prologue that is already on the website.
Yeah.
So it's
God-Eater.com.
And actually, with that, you can watch pretty cool prologue.
Animated by UFOTable. Pretty cool. So, you know, so we talked about the universe, but where do the both games, God Eater Resurrection and God Eater 2 Rage Burst, fit within this universe?
So, like we said, we have this prologue happening around the 2050s, and God Eater Resurrection happens in the 2070s.
Okay.
And you start the game with God Eater Resurrection.
It's the start of the story.
So, yeah. So, when you will be, you know, pre-ordering God Eater 2 Rage Burst or buying God Eater 2 Rage Burst and getting for free God Eater Resurrection, we strongly advise you to start with God Eater Resurrection because that's the start of the story. And you will end up at the end of God Eater Resurrection with a gap of 3 years before starting on God Eater 2 Rage Burst.
Okay.
So there is still the story is still happening during these 3 years, but it's not through the video games themselves.
So, gosh, how many hours of gameplay is that?
It's more than 100
hours. That's a lot of, you're getting lots of bang, that's for sure.
And let's say you have, every time you get these monsters that we call Aragami, mm-hmm. and you've got these missions where you have all the story and so on, and every time you can replay and find new elements to craft specific weapons, so you can play for your whole life if you want.
So yeah, before we go into deeper into the games, let's talk a bit about the Western key art, because I'm sure fans noticed that our cover of the game is different from the Japanese cover, but it's pretty cool, actually. I really like it. So
actually,
can we explore it a bit? I think you can see it on screen right now. Yeah.
What we wanted to do with this key art, this piece of artwork, was bringing all the notions of, you know, post-apocalyptic world. You know, you see the monster and you see the character, and having this ratio, you know, David versus Goliath,
that's really cool.
This kind of threatening and imminent death. We wanted to bring all these elements with the monster.
Okay.
And picking this character was really important for us because Livy, that's the name of the character, is really important in for the story of God Eater 2 Rage Burst. And her god arc, which is a weapon, which is a scythe here, is really important also in terms of battle system. So having these two elements was really important, and we wanted to bring, you know, this post-apocalyptic world. You can see, if you pay attention to, you know, a broken car that has been destroyed by an Aragami, which is the monster.
Yeah.
And you have lots of small elements that are into this piece of art, which is really, really nice. I think so.
Yeah, it's really cool. And it was, I mean, the creation was actually supervised by the art director of on God Eater. So
yeah,
that's pretty
cool. They provided so many great feedback, so we could implement everything into this piece of art.
Yeah, I mean, I love it. It's really badass. It looks really cool, and you just want to get into the fight. You want to fight that monster with Livy.
Actually, what we're going to do, you know, on the website, we are going to put an article on how we created this piece of art.
Awesome.
With all the various, you know, declinations, variations, and from the ideas to the final piece of art. So
the making of, yeah.
Yeah, the making of. So I think it's going to be interesting for a lot of you guys.
Yeah, stay tuned on god-eater.com.
Yeah.
So let's talk about, you know, you talk about Livy, which is a character. I mean, as your player, you create your own character.
Yeah.
So can we talk a bit about character customization, which is in our next video?
Yeah, so character customization, it's really important because you will be, every time you will be playing a God Eater game, you will be creating your own character.
Okay.
And this character will be depicted through, you know, the animated scenes within the games. And you will have the possibility to choose, you know, accessories, the color of the skin. You can have, you can even choose the voice itself.
Right.
You have so this is really good to tailor the experience you will have into the God Eater games.
So it's really, you are the main character. You are the hero of the game.
Yeah, you are the hero of the game. And what you can do also is when you are online, you know, playing multiplayer.
Yeah.
We'll talk about it a bit later, maybe in June or July.
Yeah.
But you will be able to see your friend's character. So that's really a good point.
Yeah, and I mean, you'll see, you can see it a bit in this video, but you can really create your own customized character. Like, no character can look alike. It can look really different and unique, and that's pretty cool, actually. So can you tell us a bit more about the gameplay of the series?
Yes. So God Eater, the main thing to keep in mind is the fact that you are fighting these monsters.
Okay.
Because there is a story happening and you've got to go into missions outside the secured city to discover new elements, to find members or, you know, this kind of elements. And you will be fighting these monsters that we call Aragami.
Yeah, the Aragami.
And you will have this weapon that we call the God Arc. And the God Arc is, yeah, it's actually really interesting because the God Arc is the only weapon that can kill these Aragamis.
Okay.
Because Aragamis come from, you know, a specific cell that they've discovered in the 2050s.
Mm-hmm.
And let's say they discovered these cells and the cells evolved and managed to evolve and
consume.
You know, consume everything in terms of buildings and everything. And it adapted to its outer environment.
Yeah.
So when they try to kill it with standard weapons, it just evolved again, and they were completely immune to it.
Yeah.
Therefore, the Fenrir organization had to come up with another weapon.
Right.
That is the God Arc. And the God Arc, you know, you will be able to play with Variants mode because it's a polymorph weapon, meaning that you can have the blade form for, you know, close contact. You can have the gun form, and, you know, so for long range attacks.
Yeah.
And you can have another mode that is really interesting, we call the Predator mode.
Predator mode, okay.
So it's some kind of bio mechanism that can eat the Aragami. And with that, you will have, you know, exclusive elements to use during the fight. So using these three ways of attacking the monsters is really interesting because you will see some complementarities with using them.
So, yeah, and I saw lots of, actually, diversity in weapons. I mean, it doesn't have to be just a sword. It can be like a scythe, like with Livy.
Yeah, yeah.
It can be...
It could be a long sword, long blade, short blade, scythe, hammer, spear.
Yeah.
And this is just for the close-range attacks. For the long-range attacks, you also have other types, you know, of fire guns. So you can have snipers and so on.
Yeah.
And for the Predator, you also have some specific elements that you'll soon discover. But with that, it's really it tailors the way you want to fight. So it will depend on your specific likings, on the way you want to kill the Aragamis and discover the various, you know, weak points. Because each Aragami will have specific weak points.
Each one is different,
Yeah, each one is different, has specific attack patterns.
Yeah.
And, you know, you, for instance, on the forearm will be sensitive to electricity. So you might want to craft a specific weapon using electricity to end the fight quicker.
Okay, so before we move on, I mean, got into to Rage Burst. It says right there in the title, Rage Burst. I think that's something about the gameplay, right?
Yeah. So Gaeta to Rage Burst is really important because once you master Gaeta Resurrection, there is another element in Gaeta to Rage Burst. It's the Rage mode.
Right.
And with that, you have specific challenges to fulfill. And if you, during the fight.
Yeah, you can see that on screen, actually, on
the
video.
For instance, if you say that you want to have specific amount of damage on the Aragami, the monster, and you manage to reach this amount of damages, you enter into a Rage mode, so you are faster, stronger, and that's really a huge plus into the fight because the longer you stay into a fight, the more chances you have to die.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, the Aragami are really dangerous foes, so you need to end the fight quickly.
Yeah.
And Rage Burst can help you get stronger quickly.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. So, I mean, there are lots of other monster slaying games. You know, there's Monster Hunter, there's Tsukiden, there's Attack on Titan. So what's so special about God Eater?
I think the main thing that people will like with the God Eater is the storyline.
Okay.
It's really the only element and the main element that is binding everything, because you have the, you know, these missions, but with the missions, because for another game it's just going outside and kill the monsters and coming back. And here the reason why you go on missions is just through the story. Before starting the mission, you might have an animated scene.
Yeah.
Ending the mission, you have an animated scene, and you will follow a specific storyline.
Yeah. And with intrigue and, you know, characters. Yeah.
And what you'll see actually through the story, because it's really rich, and you will see that maybe monsters are not the only threat. That's the only thing I will say.
Interesting. Mystery. Lots of mystery. I guess we'll find out when the game comes out.
Yeah.
So yeah, just to recap, God Eater is coming out on PS4, PS Vita, and PC on August 30th. And for all the info we just said about pre-order, the special buy one, get one offer, and more, tune into god-eater.com, join the community, leave your comments, and yeah, learn more about this incredible universe.
Yes.
Thank you for coming over, Jerome.
Thank you. Have a nice day and see you really soon.
Yeah, we'll see you soon for more info. We'll leave you now with the latest on to the how to win a PlayStation 4. We'll be right back.
16.
Tell me, have you ever wondered from whence the origami come? History books tell us that they just appear, as though they are ripping through the very core of evolutionary process.
The origami exist only to hunt, only to kill.
I hate being the guy to break it to you, but death is not so rare out here.
Origami will purge this world.
Humans and origami cannot live together.
Let's go!
Could you put him down?
If you are to fight this beast, you must do it with caution and strategy.
The rescue squad is on the way.
Whoa!
We ourselves have become the Eater of Gods!
Think hard and have no regrets.
Till the bitter end.
And we're back. Thank you once again, everybody, for tuning in to our Banner Live episode 3. We hope you liked it. Please leave us your comment, leave us your feedback, and we'll be sure to take them into account as we strive to make each episode better, of course. Let us know. Actually, I think I forgot something. Before we leave, you think you're here to win a PlayStation 4, right? A PlayStation 4. Are you ready? It's now or never. Are you ready to win? So, my colleague in the back is preparing everything so it's ready. Gaetan, it's ready? It's ready. You just need to type in the chat, Banalive. B-A-N-A-L-I-V-E, Banalive. That's it. Lowercase, Banalive. You enter that in the chat and you'll be entered in the giveaway to win a PlayStation 4. It's now or never. And we'll tell you the name of the winner in just a bit. So yeah, take your time, enter the giveaway. And in just a few minutes, we'll announce the winner in the chat and on the stream. We really hope you enjoyed staying with us today. To learn more about Sword Art Online, Hollow Realization, Tales of Berseria, God Eater, the God Eater games. Please, they all have websites and awesome communities to join. We really hope you'll be part of our community and help us make those games more known outside and bring in your friends. And yeah, so I hope you're all entering the PlayStation 4 giveaway. And if you're watching the replay, of course, the giveaway is not running anymore. So that was only live. So yeah, thanks for tuning in and we'll see you next time. See you guys.